Asker here from Breakthrough Trading, and happy Friday to everyone. So I wanted to do another market review for this week, and of course this week hasn't been the best week. It didn't turn out exactly as we wanted. All of these Japanese JPY positions unfortunately hit stop loss, most of them. At this point I'm just carrying this GBP JPY that might recover, maybe not, and I'm carrying some metas and a little bit of everything. But yes, of course, this is not what we wanted. We didn't want all our profits being wiped out by one spike in the Japanese markets, but here we are. So Andrew and I have been working all week seeing, well, what can we do and what can we change and what needs to happen here to make sure this doesn't happen again, and also how do we move forward from this? Because it is quite a dilemma. Either you have to use a really large stop loss and to avoid the volatility in the market and avoid being kicked out of these trades when you're in them while the trend is still active, or you need a very tight stop loss that only gets kicked out when it's absolutely necessary, right? So we've been looking at this, we've been trying to see, well, what can we actually, you know, what can we do here to let me see if I can find a decent market we can look at here. What can we actually do here to change the trading strategy so it becomes better and improves? And I pulled out an old project of mine that I've been working on, some time ago that I put away because we focused on a different part of the strategy. And now I have pulled it out again and I have some pretty interesting results to share. But first, allow me to explain what it's actually doing here. So let me just see. Okay, here we have a good market. Okay, so this is just AUD, New Zealand dollar. And all we've been doing, you know, for the past months has really been mean reversion market making, right? So we've been waiting for the market to dive, then we've been picking it up in these zones where, you know, the market's basically out of bounds. It's, you know, it's mispriced, and we can make some profit off that mispricing, that temporarily volatility that has driven the market out of bounds. It has brought us to a point where we can make profit from it, right? So that's what we've been doing so far. Now the problem is that sometimes we get trapped in these positions after the market has already weakened too much and they never recover. So the alternative is that if you don't do mean reversion market making like this, well, what can you do? Well, there's some other things you can do. And I can't talk too much about exactly what it is. Some say this is illegal. trading, you're not exactly allowed to do this. You're not allowed to use this approach and so on. But I don't really care about that. Also, I don't think that's true at all. It really determines how you look at it and how it's being applied. But in our case, it's not the case. So I want to explain something, and let's see if we can find like a trending example here. Okay, so this is just an example. You can try to understand what it is that we're going to try and what I have tried with the backtest that have yielded some really good profits. So here I'm going to show you this first, and we'll show you the backtest after. So what you can see here, you know, it's just like any market structure, a market that's pushing up. But as you can see, it's barely coming down to touch the 1 minute band. Most of the action is actually happening here in a neutral zone between the resistance and the neutral band here. Resistance and the support here. And of course, this is different for every market. Ideally, you know, we want a really, really strong market like New Zealand dollar CAD here, like this example right here. And of course, there's a trade already going on here. We're just going to take it out of that because it's not important. And so traditionally, we've been trading the support of the resistance band. But what we're trying to attempt now, and that I have done with some successful results, is actually move the entry, instead of being from the support of the resistance, to being the neutral point and the midway point of the market. And of course, this only works when the market is trending really strong in one direction. But during that time, we can find a small gap in the market where it's trending really strong in one direction, and we can actually make a lot of money. And that's like this, you can see here, where it's just trending really strong in one direction. And as long as we have this active algorithm online that's selling off here, that's selling all of this inventory here, we can actually jump in and we can participate as a liquidity provider and make money. But we don't have to trade on the 1 minute band. We can actually trade, I'm sorry, on the support band. We can actually trade at the direct price of the market and make money from it. So let me just show you what this actually looks like in our back test. Okay, so first I'm going to show you this this backtest TV running. Let me see. Here we go. It should be working. Let me slow it down a little bit. Okay. So these are. This is just a quick interface so you can see kind of what's going on here, and I'll show you what I'm looking at. Okay. So here we go. Gonna speed this up a little bit. Let's see if we can find a trade. So it's just trading. It doesn't trade as much as before. Before we basically traded at every opportunity that we could. Now this one will only trade in some very selective market environments. And that's because of how it works, because it trades at the mid level instead of at the neutral level rather than the support resistance. So it is, very much focused on finding really strong markets with really strong trends in one direction and then joining them, participating in them. Okay, here we go. Let's see if we can slow this down a little bit. Okay. So you can see here we have sold this level here, and we're looking for a TP down here. It's a position of 2.27 lots, and we have a stop loss up here at the 5 minute level, right? So this is a really tight situation, and yet, watch. There's the TP. There we come. There we go. Some more. So you can see it's the same. We're trading this 5 minute stop loss here, and we have the TP at 1 minute and 5 minutes. So it's really interesting. And you can see it's only in very specific situations. We already took it off, so we're not trading this anymore. We have some really good detection built in now to detect the patterns of the market and the direction of how the order flow is going. And when the order flow turns around and we can see that it's already turning around, we don't trade this anymore. We only want to trade with this as long as we can see the order flow is going in the direction that we wish to trade. So we have some really good detection on making sure as soon as there's anything that goes against anything we want to see, we stop trading it. And you have to, because we're trading with a 5 minute stop loss. So anytime that you're wrong the slightest, it's going to cost you. So you really have to be confident in these positions. And that's what we're working on here. And I think it's looking really positive. Let me see. We got some more here. So you can see it's just waiting. We're not really getting it yet. Let's see if we can get it. You can see it's just chasing it down as the market comes down. Let's see. Here we got an entry. Let's see if we get a second entry up here at the 5 minute. And you can see it's just kind of leaning over. And that's the interesting that's the interesting aspect. And then you get the spike. So yeah, this is the strategy. But let me show you the results of this. Let me actually show you what this looks like when we look at the results. Right. So let's go here. Let's do this one more time. 17% risk is set in the settings. Oh, this time we're gonna do it without the visualizer because otherwise it takes too long. So this is a full back test since you can see it starts trading around 2022 and then around April 2022, beginning 2022, and it trades all the way until I think October 2023. So of course, you know what I'm sitting here working on now is trying to reduce these stops that we do get hit sometimes, you know, and it happens because if we can knock this out, and I'm already taking out many of these, if we can keep taking this out, we can get a very nice and smooth line, but already equity curve. But look at this, it's already really nice. So you can see when we look at the back test, you can see we have a sharp ratio of 6.12, a profit factor of 1.82, and we have a max drawdown of 18%. And we set the risk to 17%, so 18% is really good. We make a total net profit of 10,500, and we have a total of 144 trades. So this is pretty good. It's a completely different approach with a limited risk. You're not gonna sit in those drawdowns, but you might hit some stops, you know, and those stops will cost. But this is a completely different approach, and it will work really well for small accounts as well. And I think this will be an addition to the current version of the strategy. It will be switching between the mean reversion market making strategy and this front running approach. It's not really front running, and front running is, you know, illegal in some markets. It's not really. We're really just participating as a liquidity provider and just trading it. That's all there is to it. But some might classify this as something else, but it's not. So yeah, this is looking really well. We're really happy with this, and now of course it is getting this to work. But of course, this will be trading a lot less than the previous version. However, it will be making a lot more money per trade because of the stop loss that's put at the five minute stop loss, at the 5 minute band, which means we can really pump up the risk on these trades when we are confident in the direction of it. So yeah, this is what we're gonna keep working on. I hope we can push this out for a test pretty soon. It'll probably be starting of next month. And we're never gonna give up. It doesn't matter what happens here. We're gonna keep working on this until it's perfect and until it's just an absolutely money printer. And I think this approach we have here tonight that I'm looking at here is looking really good. So yeah, thank you for being part of it. Thank you for being patient and working with us on this. You have to remember, this is bigger than all of us. This is a mission to help, you know, reduce people's addictions to trading and get people away from this so they can focus on their own life, right? Because humans are not meant to be sitting in front of the screen doing manual trading, especially not now with all the AI developments that's coming out. So in the future, humans will not be trading anymore. I know this for a fact because I've seen the future. No, but this is what I do believe. And if you believe this as well, then feel free to come along and join us on this journey and help us build this solution and build Breakthrough Trading out. I'll see you guys next week and have an absolutely great weekend.